It's election season. People are vying for your votes on councils all around the Motu.
You can't put a price on democracy, but the people you elect will help to set some of the charges for common household items.
We've decided to look at charges for water, parking, libraries and limbs.
And even household members. Isn't that right, Stanley?
Oh, but it's worth it. Yes, aren't you, boy?
And the charges, just like the dogs themselves, come in all shapes and sizes. Registering Bailey hasn't been an easy stroll for Felix.
150 for this little thing is more than my car registration, okay?
That's Auckland Council's early bird price to register a dog that hasn't been neutered.
Why were you furious?
Because they doubled the price.
Yes, last year he paid more than double the previous year's charge.
Dog is over 1 year old now. He's not de-sexed. Blah, 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 blah.
Bailey only uses the footpaths and other ratepayer-funded facilities for half an hour a day. And he's a good dog. He's never been in trouble. Felix is feeling the bite and doing the numbers for Tāmaki Makaurau. He reckons, OK, 100,000 dogs times $150 registration, let's say with a discount, $100.
We're looking at $10 million a year. Where do they go, this money?
It's a question we're all asking. How does what I pay compare with other places? We've put the questions to 67 local bodies and waded through the data. So here it is, the Fair Go Challenge on Council Charges, Round 1, Dog Rego.
Pepper, no, pepper.
Top price is in Tokoroa. The Lowe's breed French Bulldogs. They might be tiny, but they're not cheap.
Oh, hello. Oh, hello, hello, hello. Oh, everybody's come to say hello.
Little nip there just to remind me who's boss.
Oh, him. Yeah. Oh, well, Frenchies are like Pringles. You get one, you can't not get another.
South Waikato District Council wants $172 a year for a domestic dog that has been neutered.
Even if you had two in town, that's what, $344, that'd feed a family for a week.
The Lowe's pay less because they're on a rural property, $432 a year in total for the pack, but they do wonder what they're getting for that. South Waikato District Council says Dog Rego pays nearly half of what it costs to run a superior service, with rates covering the rest. The team attend every complaint in person, roaming, barking, welfare. It also offers payment plans to spread the cost. From here, it gets cheaper, slightly. New Plymouth District Council wants $163.50 for a domestic dog that's been neutered. Porirua wants $134. Chatham Islands Council asks just $44 for that dog, Island Life. Selwyn District wants $45, and the Alpha Dog, Kawero, just $37 a year for registration.
That is a fraction of what it costs in the big cities, and that is one reason that we're here in Kawero to award the council the unofficial Fair Go Value Ribbon for Best in Show.
Time to meet the leaders of the pack.
Kawero is so together that it's already got its next mayor lined up, along with its long-running your Worship. And we've got a little award to give them today. The Top Dog Award for Kawero, cheapest dog registration for a de-sexed animal in the town limits. I'd like to convey that to you with all of our best respects. And well done.
Thank you. Thank you, Garth. Cool.
Keeping the cost low means more register. From pooches to property, next on Fair Go's checklist, limbs. Welly, Palmy and the Grey District all want over $400 for a limb. Central Otago will charge $185, but the cheapest at $168.
Kawero also has the trimmest limb. Now, that's the report that you get if you're trying to get a house, so I'd like to hand that over to you as well, if I could, sir.
Thank you very much for that, Guy.
Still in the K, as locals say, savings continue outside.
It's also free to park here in the main street, although that is an honour that Kawero will have to share with 46 other local authorities.
It's the usual suspects charging to park. Auckland, Wellington, Christchurch and Queenstown Lakes District Council don't think we can't see you either. All want $4 to $5 an hour for main street parking.
Of course, if parking fees are the reason you aren't getting your library books back on time, relax in Auckland and Kawero, and in 38 other places where they tell us they don't charge late fees.
Napier Public Library will want $4.20 if you're a week late. It's $3.50 in half a dozen places, including back in Tokoroa at the South Waikato District Council. And many charge a fee to borrow a bestseller or hot item. Right now, this is the hottest item for councils. Why? No, not why. Why? Water. We're hearing a lot about three waters, but let me tell you, it's hard to find out and compare the cost of what comes out of your taps. About a third have you on a meter. Kaipara seems cheap at $4.18 for 1,000 litres or 1,000 glasses of tap water for a dollar. But the best deal for metered water looks like Opotiki at 56 cents for 1,000 litres. That's more than 7,000 glasses of tap water for a dollar. Some councils just lump water into the rates bill, so no idea what you're paying really. Others are charging a flat fee, anything from $200 to more than $800 a year with various T's and C's. But the lowest is... ting! Kawaro, take a bow once more.
$82?
Yes, yes. The cheapest water supply in the country. And that's, there, don't get me going on water supply right now, please.
There's a reason they can keep things cheap. Some big businesses pay a lot of rates, but it is also part of a big vision to take care of the basics first.
It's somewhere to live, somewhere to work so that we can earn an income, to create a life for our family, something to hope for so we leave something behind for our kids. And if we take care of those three things, Garth, hopefully we can find someone to love on the journey and look after us. That's the dream.
That's appealing, but we can't stay. Back in Auckland, we have some answers for Felix. Auckland Council spends about $15 million a year managing dogs and gets $10 million of that from registrations and fees charged by the pound. Bailey's first rego was cheap because it was for what was left of that year. The good news is Felix can halve the cost next year if he passes a written test to prove he's a responsible owner. The test is free. Till then, these two will keep getting their money's worth out of the footpaths.